Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with another tutorial video, and in this video I'll teach you guys how you can fix Elementor not authorized to read or write from this file. So if you are trying to import a template kit and you are seeing this error, and if you are seeing the issue in your Elementor when you click on system info, you're seeing write permissions issue. So as it's saying, there are some writing permission issues with the following directories and files. As you can see, I'm having this issue with htaccess file. So in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how you can fix this. Please stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Comment the video below if you want to learn more about web design, development, Shopify, Elementor, or anything you would like to see in this YouTube channel. Without further ado, let's jump into fixing this. So guys, we were developing this website for a client and we were trying to import template kit on this website. That's how we saw this error, and we googled out what is the possible cause of this issue, and we fixed that issue. And I thought I should create a video for you guys, and if you face that kind of issue, you can easily fix that. So I'm creating this website in Elementor 3.7.7. Currently I'm using a free version. I haven't added Elementor Pro version. There are multiple free add-ons which I will use to create this website, but before that, let's fix that issue. So in order to fix this issue, you can do this using a file manager plugin, or if you have file manager access through your cPanel. In this case, I have cPanel access, so I'll be fixing this issue via file manager, and that is the file where we need to go. Plugins, Elementor, modules, and within that we have system info, reporters, and that, and then server.php. That's the file where we will be going and commenting one of the line to fix the issue. So guys, I have already logged in to the cPanel account. Now I'm going to go to the file manager. From file manager, let's go to public HTML. So my domain was pointed directly to public HTML. If your website is in subdomain, you'll have to find where your domain is pointed to. So after going to public HTML, I'm going to go to WP content, and then as per the root of the file, plugins, Elementor, and modules, system info. And here we have reporters, and then server.php. So that's the file where we will be commenting out one of the line to fix that issue. Now click on edit file, edit again, and then scroll down. So that's the function which we need to find, get write permissions. You need to search public function get underscore write permission, and in that function you can see that we have this line where it's asking to request the write access. We'll simply comment this line out, and after commenting this line, click on save. And then if we go back to our system info in Elementor and hit refresh, as you can see, we are not seeing this issue anymore and it's been fixed. And now let's try to import the template kit. So in order to import, let me walk you through where you can import your template kit. So click on Elementor tools, then import export kit. Here you have option to export a template kit and import a template kit. I was trying to import a template kit when we faced that issue. I'm gonna try that again. Click on start import, select file, and click on Elementor kit, and here we go. Our issue has been resolved. We can now successfully import the template kit. Now, if I uncomment that line again, click save, go back and try to re-import the kit. Tools, import, export, import a template kit, select file, that's my template kit. As you can see, I'm seeing this error again. So all you gotta do is go to server.php on this folder and comment out the line where it says htaccess after finding the get write permissions function. So just comment that out and you will be good to go with your issue. If you like the video, don't forget to comment out and let me know what you would like to learn in Shopify, Elementor, WordPress, whatever you want to learn with web designing and development. Until next video, have a great day.